What's up guys, this is the third episode of AI News. My name is Salim Shaimi and in this episode we are going to talk about Capsule Networks. To begin with, I would like to present you Geoffrey Hinton. Okay, it's a cognitive psychologist and computer scientist that is known for his work on artificial neural networks, that are algorithms that take inspiration from the human brain. And Hinton is one of the pioneers of deep learning. It's one of the first researchers that introduced backpropagation algorithm, and it's the reason why deep learning works so well today. But that hasn't been always the case in the past. Okay, Hinton always believed in neural networks, but most people thought it wouldn't work. Most people gave up on this idea, but he kept pushing it.
Most people stopped working on them.
But you didn't stop. You kept at it.
It seemed to me there was no other possibility. The brain has to work somehow. And neural networks are a simplified model of how the brain works.
Did people tell you, Geoffrey, you're wasting your time. Think of something else to do.
Many times. When I was doing my PhD, my advisor would tell me that every week.
And what'd you say back?
I would say, well, give me another 6 months and I'll prove to you that it works. And every 6 months I would say that again.
In 2013, he joined Google with two graduate students because they showed that the artificial neural networks permitted computers to understand images much better. And now, Hinton is deeply suspicious of backpropagation algorithms. So I quote, "My view is throw it all away and start again." In his opinion, it's just not how the brain works. But last week, Hinton introduced two research papers that he says confirm an idea he has been pondering for about 40 years. This new approach is called Capsule Networks, and it's intended to make computers better understand the world around them. Okay, so there are two papers. The first paper showed how Capsule Networks matched the accuracy of previous techniques, so when computers were told to recognize handwritten digits. And in the second paper, Hinton introduced how his Capsule Networks halved the best error rates. So when machines were told to recognize toys such as pets, cars and trucks. Okay, so now I want to present you convolutional neural networks, and that's the actual state of the art in machine learning, but they have some shortcomings. For example, you must feed them with a large amount of data. Okay, you have no choice, you must do it. And you must do it because they are very bad at generalizing data. If you don't give them a large amount of data, they wouldn't understand that, for example, an object remains the same from a new angle. Okay? And let's say you want to build an algorithm that recognizes a cat from many angles. So you would have to gather thousands of photos covering many angles and many perspectives of cats. And Hinton don't think that it's how the brain works, and I think he's right, because a human child doesn't need a variety of new scenarios to recognize a pet. So what Capsule Networks does is tracking different parts of an object, so we can say cat's nose and ears, for example, and their positions in space. And this awareness can be used to understand that an object remains the same from a new angle. In other words, it will be possible to generalize the data to new scenarios, and so extract more understanding from a given amount of data than existing systems. And I have to say that Capsule Networks are still slower than existing systems. But Hinton is optimistic that he can overcome the shortcomings, and we will see how well it performs on huge image collections. If it's successful, it could be extremely helpful for many industries, such as healthcare, for example, because image collections are scarcer. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope that you liked this video. If so, don't forget to share it. You can also follow me on social media where I'm posting about artificial intelligence and technology, okay, so Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. And if you want to learn more about AI and technology, you can go look at my blog, salimshaimi.com, where I'm posting articles about it.